Myself, Dr. Kodarkar CS from Department of Physics, Sri Siddheshwar Mahavidyalaya, Majalgaon. Today I am going to discuss very interesting chapter of your syllabus known as photoelectric effect. We discuss some contents of this chapter. Firstly, we discuss what is photoelectric emission, then photoelectric effect. After that, laws of photoelectric effect. Experimental demonstration of photoelectric effect. Using this experiment, observations of photoelectric experiment, some important terms of photoelectric effect, and lastly, we discuss Einstein's equation of photoelectric effect. Firstly, we discuss what is meant by photoelectric emission. This is the phenomena which observed by Hertz in 1887. The emission of electrons from a metal surface when electromagnetic radiation is incident upon it is called photoelectric emission. Means when light is fall on the metal surface, electrons are emitted. That process is called as a photoelectric emission. This experiment was influenced by ultraviolet light. After that, we see that what is photoelectric effect? It is the phenomena of emission of electrons from the surface of metals when light radiations of suitable frequency fall on them. Means this light having suitable frequency, that frequency electrons are emitted from the metal surface. This is known as photoelectric effect, and these emitted electrons are called photoelectrons, and the current is called photoelectric current. For alkali metal shows photoelectric effect with visible light, whereas metal shows the effect only on ultraviolet light. In this experiment, light energy is converted into electrical energy. After that, some laws of photoelectric effects are present. First law is photoelectric emission is instantaneous. Means when light is fall on the metal surface, within second, electrons are emitted. These 10 raised to minus 8 seconds means very, very small time is required to emit the electron from metal surface. For that purpose, first law is photoelectric emission is instantaneous. The rate of photoelectric current is directly proportional to intensity of incident light. What is meant by intensity? Intensity, it totally depends upon how many photons are present in the incident light. And that intensity of incident light, rate of photo current is directly proportional. Third is, light of frequency less than some minimum frequency will not be able to emit photoelectrons. Means minimum frequency is required to emit the electron. That frequency is known as a threshold frequency. Its value is different for different substances, and kinetic energy of emitted photoelectrons increases with increase in energy of incident light. This is an experiment. In this experiment, we show that this is evacuated glass tube which contains two electrodes. One is known as an emitter and another is known as a collector. Electromagnetic light is fall on the surface of emitter plate. When emitter plate emits electrons, that electrons are known as a photoelectrons. In the circuit, ammeter is connected. This ammeter is used to measure current in the circuit. As well as a voltmeter is also connected in the circuit to measure voltage in the circuit. One communicator key is present. This key is used to make collector plate positive as well as negative with respect to emitter. Using this experiment, for taking different readings, we draw a graph between photo current and collector plate potential. Collector plate potential on x-axis and photo current on y-axis. In this graph, we show that we make cathode negative as well as zero as well as positive potential. Collector can be made negative minus Vs. This potential is known as a retarding potential or stopping potential. At stopping potential, photo current is equal to zero. And when we make collector plate potential positive, we show that photo current goes on increasing. Even if frequency of incident light is same for different intensity. If intensity goes on increasing, photo current is also goes on increasing. These are observations of the photoelectric effect. First observation is intensity of incident radiation is varied, keeping the frequency constant. At a certain value above the threshold frequency, as intensity increases, photoelectric current increases. Threshold frequency is minimum frequency. Above that frequency, electrons can be emitted from the metal surface. Second is potential difference between collector and emitter is varied for a given radiation, keeping intensity constant. Means we can change collector and emitter voltage between these by keeping intensity constant. We can make collector more and more positive. That time what happened? The emitted electrons can be attracted towards cathode and current goes on increasing and reaches to its maximum value. When we make collector more and more negative, this emitted electrons reject from the cathode and current becomes zero or current goes on decreasing. Stopping potential means that type of potential at that point photoelectric current is equal to zero. After that, we get some important terms of photoelectric effect. First term is work function. Work function is an energy which is spent to extract the electron from the metal. It is denoted by symbol phi. Means electron can be injected from the metal surface. Some energy is required. That energy is known as a work function. Second is threshold frequency. Threshold frequency is denoted by letter nu zero. For a given metal, photoelectric emission for a certain minimum frequency of light. This frequency is minimum frequency to emit the electron from the metal surface. And third term is stopping potential, which is denoted by V0. Photoelectric current falls to zero for a certain positive potential V0 on the cathode, and it is denoted by symbol V0. And after these three important terms, lastly, we define Einstein's equation of photoelectric current. When electrons or photons incident on the metal surface, it is utilized for two purposes. First is free electrons for metal surface, or inject the free electron from metal surface, and remaining energy is required for to provide kinetic energy of emitted electrons. Therefore, energy of electrons is E is equal to H nu, where H is Planck's constant and nu is frequency. Therefore, total energy H nu is equal to Em plus phi. Phi is work function to eject electron from the metal surface, and Em is kinetic energy of electron. Therefore, Em is equal to H nu minus phi, where nu zero is threshold frequency. Then work function phi is equal to H nu zero. Putting value of phi in the equation, we get Em is equal to H nu minus H nu zero. We can take common H from these two terms. Em is equal to H into bracket nu minus nu zero, and this is master equation which is derived by Einstein, and it is calculated all the characteristics of photoelectric effect. After that, we can also calculate E by M of photoelectrons by using Lennard's method. In second lecture, we can discuss about Lennard's method. Thank you. We can stop here.